This is going to be a very short message. I've made a summary before in which I've spoken about when you feel like something wrong is going on, in which I've spoken about how your energy field can sense danger, can sense negative, intoxicated energies. I've spoken about it. I want to remind you in this audio recording that if you sense, I'm not talking about just suspicion or people that, I'm not talking about suspicion that is just based upon nothing. I'm not talking about some, okay, you get what I'm saying here, right? I'm talking about when you sense in your spirit as if something is up. Like you're in your house, you're right, you have no debt collectors coming at you now, the rent is paid, you have food in-house, everything is completely fine, there are no lawsuits against you, none of that. But you sense as if there is something growing, some hostility growing somewhere. Now look, if you've sensed this, first check if you've slept enough, if you've eaten enough. Don't just assume things, okay? But if you sense that indeed there's objectively something going on, then let me tell you, most of the time you're right. There is something going on. You can sense it. People call it the sixth sense. It's alarm system of your soul that's operating that way. Okay, maybe you are, okay, let's say you work at a law firm. I'm just giving an example. And you just get this feeling that something is up. And you feel physically ill in your stomach because of it. But you have no stomach issues. Your stomach works perfectly fine, but still you sense something in your belly as if there's something wrong happening, as if there's some kind of explosion about to happen. And let me tell you what it is. Somewhere, there are people who are meditating negatively about you, or they are planning something against you. And this hateful energy is sent into the atmosphere. And at a distance, your soul senses this hostile rage, but your soul cannot decode what it is. Your body reacts to this sense that your soul receives, and your body begins to make hormones that will make you feel uncomfortable. But what you notice is your body making those hormones and make you feel comfortable, and you will feel it somewhere in your body, whether it's in your back or in your stomach, or maybe as a migraine in your head, you sense the outworking, but often you're not aware that it's a warning signal that comes from your soul. But let's say you work at a law firm and you feel this. It can be that there is a complaint filed against you somewhere, and now the judges are deciding whether or not you need to be arrested. That's going on. Because there are people who were just upset because of something you said once, that you didn't mean to harm anyone, but they felt upset, and now they are meditating upon it over and over again. With meditating upon it, they are rethinking, they are in resentment, and they're about to explode. They're about to take out the resentment on someone. And now they hope to get some validation from the judge. But it can be that that is what is going on, and that you become feel comfortable in your stomach. That is a sign that danger is developing. I'm just using an example here. It can be something else. Look, as I mentioned before, check if you ate enough, if you slept well enough. Don't just come and assume that something's up. Just realize, often when our soul receives signs of danger, it translates itself as bodily unease. But often we're so focused on fixing the bodily unease that we don't look at the bigger picture. And listen to me, if you are from a background where a lot of people used to not like you, don't want you, or they choose to, for some reason, think bad about you and defend it, those people are still walking the earth. They get married, or they get sex partners, or they even have kids, or they're involved at jobs, and they are carrying that resentment with them. And that resentment is going to affect where they are. And if they are still feel comfortable to blame you, they will lie about you towards others, and others, if they are susceptible, if they are vulnerable, they will believe them. So then you will have a crowd against you. And listen to me carefully. If there is a crowd that has agreed against you, you are facing trouble. Because when a crowd has agreed upon something and they're so emotionally involved, the crowd tends to lose it. They tend to go towards mass insanity against the target. So look, this is what you do. Every time you feel uncomfortable, just begin to praise the Lord, begin to decree His word. Maybe you don't have to speak out loud. You don't have to speak out loud, especially if you're in public, but begin to meditate upon the word of God. Use the sword of the Spirit. Use your spiritual armor, I mean for real. You don't feel like that for nothing. It's either something in your body that has an imbalance, or it's due to shortage of sleep, or it may be unprocessed trauma, if that's the case. But if it's none of that, and there is no direct cause, then you know what it is. Too often people ignore spiritual warning signals. Now you know better. When you sense that discomfort, no, it's not from the Lord. So don't accept it. Don't take it as normal. That being said, be at peace.